गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू द वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ साइंस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट चैप्टर नंबर 6 एनिमल लाइफ, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टेरेस्ट्रियल एनिमल्स, एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स, एरियल एनिमल्स, आर्बोरियल एनिमल्स एंड एम्फीबियंस। नाउ हेयर इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर we will be doing the rest part of this chapter. Okay, so let's begin. I hope you have understood the different types of animals based on their habitats, like terrestrial animals, aquatic animals, arboreal animals, aerial animals and amphibians. So different animals eat different types of food, and according to their food habits, animals can be classified or categorized as herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, parasites and scavengers. So let's discuss them one by one. First one is herbivores. Animals that eat only plants or plant product are called herbivores or plant eating animals. Those animals that eat only plant material are known as the herbivores, and the grazing animals like sheep, horses, cow and zebra eat grass and leaves and are the important examples of herbivores. So the animals which eat only plant and plant product, they are the herbivores. They have sharp and flat front teeth for cutting the leaves. Cow, sheep, buffalo, deers and goats are the examples of herbivores. So herbivores have sharp and flat front teeth and they use these teeth for the cutting, for cutting the leaves. Okay, they are used for cutting. And there are so many examples of herbivores like cow, sheep, buffalo, deer, goat, zebra, horses, all are the examples of herbivores. Elephants and giraffes also eat leaves of the trees. Elephants have strong teeth which allow them to eat twigs and sugarcane. Elephants and giraffes are also known as herbivores because they only eat plants or plant product. They have strong and long legs which help them to cover long distances in search of food. And these herbivores have the long and strong legs like the elephant. You can see in this picture also, they have the long and strong legs, and these legs help them to cover long distances in search of food. Long neck of giraffe help it to reach leaves of tall plants. So giraffe has the long neck, and this long neck help it to reaches to the leaves of the tall plants. Okay, so giraffe and elephants are also herbivores. Some birds like parrot are also herbivore which eat only fruits and nuts. Okay, so parrot is also a herbivore. Parrots have a strong curved rod and a strong tongue to take their food, and the small animals like rat, squirrel, rabbit, they are known as the rodents. Okay, because they have sharp and long front teeth. So some rodents are also herbivores, right? Now the next is carnivores. Flesh eating animals are known as carnivores, like tiger and lion feed on other animals' flesh. These animals have strong legs that help them to run fast and catch their prey. They have long pointed curved teeth, front teeth, and strong grinding teeth which help them to tear and eat the flesh. So tiger, cheetah, hyena, all are the carnivores. All these are the examples of carnivores because they depend on other animals for their food, and the carnivores include those animals that depend on animals' flesh for their food. They have sharp pointed teeth for tearing the skin and flesh, and their back teeth are also very strong and broad. So these teeth are used for chewing the bones and flesh of their prey. Some birds are also carnivores. So the birds of prey such as hawks and eagles have sharp beaks to tear the flesh. They also have strong claws called talons to catch and tear their prey. So the birds like hawk, eagle, vultures, kites, all are the carnivorous birds. They are also known as the birds of prey. Okay, and they hunt and feed on other animals. And their long and strong claws are also known as talons. They have sharp hooked beak for tearing the flesh. You can see here also. Okay, and they have sharp claws for tightly holding their prey, and their sharp claws are also known as talons. So these are the carnivorous birds. Now the next is the omnivores. Animals that eat both plants and animals are known as omnivores, like crows, cockroaches, ants, cats and bear. Human beings are also known as omnivores. So omnivores are the animals that eat both plants and flesh of other animals, that eat both plants and animals also, like crows, ant, cat, bear. All these are the omnivores. Chimpanzee is also an omnivore because chimpanzee eat fruit, leaves, nuts, seeds and stem, as well as chimpanzee eats ants, birds, eggs, fish and termites also. So chimpanzee is an example of omnivore. They also occasionally kill and eat baboons and wild pigs. There are so many other examples of omnivores like bear, crow. Human beings are also the most common example of omnivore because human beings eat both plants and animals also. So the human beings are also known as omnivores. Now the next are parasites. Animals that depend on other animals for their food are called parasites. Those animals which depend on other animals for their food are known as parasites. For example, leeches, lice, mosquitoes, bugs, roundworms, tapeworms, all are the examples of parasite because they depend on other animals for their food. They live on the bodies of other animals, which is known as host, and suck their blood. All parasites cause disease in their host. Okay, so these parasites live on the bodies of other animals, and these parasites also cause disease in their host. So there are so many examples of parasites like roundworm, leech, louse, tapeworm. All are the examples of parasites. Okay, now let's move forward. Next is scavengers. Animals that feed on dead animals and plants are called scavengers. Those animals which eat the dead animals or plants are known as scavengers. For example, vulture, raccoons, hyenas, all are the examples of scavengers. And in nature, many carnivores act as scavengers. Vulture, raccoons and hyenas, all are the carnivorous animals, so they behave like scavengers. Okay, so mostly all the carnivores are the scavengers, and these scavengers feed on dead animals and dead plants. Now the next is adaptation for protection. Every animal protect itself from its enemies and surroundings. Surroundings means from the heat of the sun, from the rain, from the cold weather conditions. So it is very important for an animal to protect itself and continue to live and reproduce. There are several ways by which animals can save themselves. Okay, so animals protect themselves or hide themselves from their enemies, and they also protect themselves from the harsh weather conditions like the heat, cold, rain, snow. Okay, and there are several ways by which animals can save themselves. So some animals escape from their enemies because of their speed and swiftness. So like deer can run very fast to hide themselves or to protect themselves from their enemies. Rabbits, hares, rats make burrows deep into the soil to escape from their enemies, such as eagles, owls and cats. Okay, because these rabbit, hare and rat are the food for eagles, owls and cats, so they protect themselves by making burrows deep into the soil. Okay. Whales, elephants and hippopotamus protect themselves from other animals by their big size. So whale, elephant and hippopotamus are very big in size, and their big size protect themselves from the other animals or from their enemies. Okay, they are too big to be eaten by other animals. So their big size protect themselves from the other animals or from the other enemies. Some animals can escape from their enemies because of their color and body shape, so that they can merge with their surrounding. Polar bear is difficult to locate in snow because of its white color. Chameleon can change its color to merge its surrounding. This is called camouflage. So many animals have body coverings that match with their surroundings, like chameleon. Due to this, they are very difficult to spot, and thus therefore they get protection against their enemies. There are so many animals which show camouflage, like frog, chameleon, polar bear, reindeer, tiger. There are so many animals, frog also, grasshopper also. There are so many animals which show camouflage. Camouflage means they change their coloring, or they can merge with their surrounding, okay, to escape from their enemies. So the mechanism of matching the body covering of a particular animal with its surrounding is known as camouflage. For example, polar bear is very difficult to find out in snow because of its white color, because snow is also white in color and polar bear is also of white in color. So it is very difficult to locate in snow that whether it is an animal or whether it is snow. Okay, so this is known as camouflage. Same with grasshopper also, same with chameleon also. All these animals show camouflage. So these animals have the ability to change their body color according to their surrounding. Tiger and zebra have stripes on their bodies which help them to merge with their surrounding, usually in long grass and plants of the forest. So these tigers can easily hide themselves because they have the same body covering which match with the surroundings. Okay, for example, the color of this tiger match with the color of these long strips. Okay, so this animals also show camouflage. Same with zebra also. Zebra strips help to hide themselves from the enemies or to escape themselves from their enemies. So there are so many animals which show camouflage. Okay, and they have the ability to change their body color. The leaf insect look like a leaf, while the stick insect look like the twigs of the plant. Their color and shape merge so well with the surrounding that it is very difficult for the enemy to detect their presence. You can see here also, this leaf insect looks same like the leaf. Okay, this is also a leaf insect. This is also a stick insect. So we cannot differentiate between the leaf and the insect because they both look alike. So it is very difficult for the enemy to detect their presence, and this process is known as the camouflage. Now next is the migration in animals. So a large variety of birds, fish, mammals and even insects also make a remarkable journey from one place to another at certain times of the year, and this movement of animals, birds, fish or insect from one place to another during a particular period of time or during the particular time of the year is known as migration. So regular movement of birds and animals in large number to escape from unfavorable condition is known as migration. So the movement of birds and animals in large numbers from the unfavorable condition to favorable condition is known as migration, and it is generally seasonal. Okay, so this migration is generally seasonal. Siberian crane migrate to India every year. So Siberian crane migrate to India every year in winters. And there are some other birds also, or you can say that there are some other migratory birds also. For example, Arctic tern. Arctic tern is a beautiful seabird, or it is also known as a champion migratory bird, and it breeds in the Arctic and spend winters in the Antarctic region. It completes one migratory round trip of almost 40,000 km, which is equivalent to the circumference of the earth. Swallows and storks breed in Europe and spend their winters in Africa. So all these are the migratory birds, and there is a large number of group of birds which are active migratory creatures. There are some migratory fishes also, like eel. Eel spend their life in rivers and travel to the sea to lay eggs, and when the eggs hatch, so the young eel travel back to the rivers. Okay. And the salmon fish, they live in the sea and travel to rivers to lay eggs, and on hatching of eggs, young salmon go back to the sea at the age of 2 or 3 years. Some migratory insects are also there, like monarch butterflies. They start their journey of migration from different centers in North America and end it in California and Mexico in the winter season. Locust is another insect that travels long distance for food. Millions of migratory locusts form a black cloud in the sky, and they consume all the vegetation in their path, leaving famine behind. So there are so many migratory animals or migratory birds are there. So with this, we have reached to the end of this chapter. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस चैप्टर वेरी वेल. दिस इज़ वेरी ईजी एंड इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर. सो थैंक यू एंड सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.